Hoi again, YouTube! I'm Dr. Kendo, and this is the Scribblenauts Unlimited Object Editor Commentaries. This is basically a series where I create your favorite characters from movie, TV shows, and gaming, and sometimes nerd and geek culture related items in the Scribblenauts Unlimited Object Editor. That's the name of this game, Scribblenauts Unlimited. So let's go ahead and open it up here, and you start off with a source object of a pixie bob for today's character, and a pixie bob is this cat-looking thing right here. It is a cat. So anyway, we're gonna move these legs all around and stuff, but the main part that I want to emphasize first off is that we're going to be using a very bleach white color. So you want that. It's very important, actually. Get that completely white color. So you have to go in and customize your color palette in this game and make sure that one is the complete whitest that it can be. And so anyway, we're going to put this alien back leg on the back legs of our character today, which is going to be Temmie from Undertale. So that's who we are creating today based on popular request. The most requested item was indeed Temmie. And so it's got a different, I guess, looking legs in the back compared to the front. And so the reason that I only put one alien leg there from the back on the back side is because then the pixie bob, you know, that cat that we started out with, it has the foot already, the one that's in the back, you know, so not only the back two legs, but the one that's in behind. It looks like the foot of the alien leg's foot. So honestly, we didn't have to use any stamp space for that. That is one feature of this game, is while it's called Scribblenauts Unlimited, there is a limit to how much of the stamps you can use to create your item. So, you know, imagine you have your creation, it's just one big object or item overall. Well, each little item from the dictionary, like Aiden Sagawa's head that we're gonna use right now, or the squid upper tentacle, which I just used for the line there to distinguish the shirt, well, any of these are stamps. So you can consider, you know, that head, this jellyfish upper tentacle piece that we're going to use. These are all stamps, and there is a limit to how many you can put on your main object overall. And so hopefully you did see back earlier, we did the 29-page library of shapes. It's just a general library there. If you see that second button down on this panel here, this is like the user panel or whatever, whenever you're in the stamps, if you go down to that second button, that's the 29-page library. It's got 29 pages of just various things, arm shapes, leg shapes, bodies, all sorts of weird things. But we took an arm, it's the mutant arm from the 10th page, and now I've just put down a sword painted entirely all black. And we don't want to see the handle of the sword or any of that, so I put that up in the hair section, and a little bit of it sticking out, but you'll see that we'll cover that up in a little bit. But the main reason was for the blade to be pointing down as extra hairs and stuff for Temmie. And we've got marshmallow done twice for the eyes, and we're going to use a pimple as the mouth right here. And it looks like our Temmie is starting to come together, but obviously needs a lot of work here on the hair, which we'll get to in just a moment. I just want to finish up the face. Temmie has kind of that simple, it's almost like Minecraft looking face in my opinion, but basically we're going to use an eyebrow to make the little curls, I guess, on the edge of the Temmie mouth. And then on the 27th page of the 29 page library, there is an arm kind of near the top right, just in the second row from the top. And we're going to use that. So that's going to be for the little connection. We're going to do it twice, actually. That's going to connect these two eyebrows and create the whole mouth as a whole. So yes, that is four stamps. Some people are going to say you could use the letter 3 for that, but you cannot. You can do it if you want to, but it doesn't look accurate to the actual Temmie, because the 3, when you take the number 3, the points on either end of that 3 are very close together, i.e., you know, the little curve on them and the edge of the 3, the points, are going to be very close together, unlike the real Temmie's face. And so anyway, we've taken the, I guess, the other piece of hair that is coming down past the chin and everything, that's lead, L-E-A-D, and then a kiwi, the fruit kiwi. The kiwi is going to be for the ear that is on Temmie's left to our right. And so now we've taken a potato for the other ear here on our left side, but Temmie's right. And a great white shark, the back fin, is finally going to be for the cat-looking ears up here. You know, the normal Temmie ears, but those other ears that we just did are like the dog-looking ears. So Temmie has both sets of ears. So that great white shark back fin is twice, of course. And then we're just going to type in fin, F-I-N, and use the organic fin to be this little spot. I guess it's the inner parts of the ears. And so that's just to distinguish and set it apart where the lines are. And of course, as I do with the Undertale characters, I create them in their black and white. I guess it's the battle colors, but you know, I like the black and white thing because when I do it in this scale, it really fits the Undertale game. You know, like, that is the quintessential Undertale thing to me, being either pixelated looking or the black and white colors. And so with that, I thought if we're going to put them in this Scribblenauts universe right here, then we'll do them in the black and white. But you can do the overworld sprite colored version of Temmie probably pretty easily. You'll just need to recolor things, maybe use a pill as the front legs and color that differently. But anyway, as we name it and get into the properties editor, I want to do what I always do when we get to the properties or scripting editor for this series. Since it's not a lot of action on screen and things, I like to read background information or fun facts about whatever characters it is that, you know, we are creating. So for today's episode, Temmie resemble a cat with dog ears while also having their normal ears and is a species of monster in the underground. Of course, all in the game Undertale. They appear in Waterfall, Temmie Village, and of course, the Tem Shop. If there was one main point you should know about Temmie outside of its physical appearance, it's that all Temmies, other than Bob, have a childish way of speaking or easily noticed speech impediment or whatever you want to call it, where the letters are either omitted or have mixed upper and lower cases. Take Hoy, I'm Temmie, for example. Being that the H is lowercased and the OI is capitalized, and then the I is lowercased in the I'm, and the T is lowercased in Temmie, where all the other letters are uppercase. So Temmie's kind of goofy like that, but we're gonna do sort of a fun, I guess, different Temmie right here. This one is gonna be different in the way that I'm gonna make it stand still, but when it gets created, it's gonna add the adjective vibrating or shaking. You could do either one. And so what I'm doing instead of how we had our other Temmie design, the first one that I showed you, this one I'm moving all of the head pieces onto the body. So where you allocate a piece in this game to is gonna reflect how it's gonna move. You know, if something's on the head, it's gonna move with all the head pieces. If it's on the leg, it's gonna move with the leg, etc., etc. Now, hopefully you'll notice when this script here was set, it says, when this object is created, add an adjective vibrating. So that's the script if you want to do it. But the idea behind putting all of those head pieces to follow the body or be on the body grid, but then moved and placed where the head is, the reasoning for this, I guess, is so that the face will sort of stand still or be moving separately while the rest of the Temmie is like vibrating and stuff. So right there, you can see it. It doesn't look just like Undertale, you know, and how Temmie starts like vibrating or shaking like crazy, but it is sort of a close likeness and a good Scribblenauts Unlimited way, I guess, of representing that. So, you know, within the limitations of Scribblenauts Unlimited, that's good enough. I think it looks hilarious. So hopefully everybody has enjoyed today's episode. Just the one character for today, but trust me, normally I create a bunch of characters, and this time I got to do a little bit more work on other projects for the channel, so it was quite good. It's quite good every now and then for me to just kind of focus on one character, give it my all, and work on a bunch of other stuff. So anyway, I love all of you in Kentopolis. You guys are the best community there is. And so, as always, I will catch you on the next vid, and thanks for viewing it.
Down the road of twists and turns, always anxious to see what's within. We can look ahead to the point of no return, to the rest of our lives as a spectacle.